In this video, we will delve into Amazon Web Services Cloud Development Environment, AWS, and specifically Cloud9, which is their IDE. So for that, we just go to any browser and type AWS. And that is the Cloud Computing Services by Amazon, Amazon Web Services, or AWS. So we click on that and we get to their main console. We have to create an account, so we sign in. This is a free account. I've already done this. So you enter your username, the password, and you sign in. Once you have your signed in account in AWS, you go ahead and click on services and select Cloud9. These are the environments that I've already selected, but let's go ahead and start one from scratch. So we click on create environment, and we title it, say, AWS_test. And an optional description could be testing IDE for AWS. We're going to create a new EC2 instance, which is the default. We leave also the new EC2 instance type to be the free tier eligible, T2.micro. These other ones, I believe, charge you, so we'll leave that one alone there. As far as the platform, we'll go ahead and select Amazon Linux 2, which is the default. We could select Ubuntu server, but we'll just leave it at Amazon Linux 2. The timeout, we leave default at 30 minutes. Network settings, default, no tags, and we click on the create button. Once we have that, now we have our environment. And if we click on the environment itself, it says it's creating it right now. This is going to take a few minutes. So the environment details are such that the name is shown here, the type of environment, an EC2 instance is here, and so on. You can see here that the instance type is the 1 gig of RAM and 1 vCPU. You can get additional services from AWS, but we're just going right now with the first level or the tier 1 type of environment. So we'll go back here to environments, and while he's finishing this up, we'll go ahead and take a small break. After a few seconds, the AWS test environment is created, and we can see here that it was successfully created. So right now we go ahead and open our Cloud9 interactive development environment. And the interesting thing about this IDE, which has come up already, it's a few things, so let's point them out. First of all, our main canvas has the welcome screen and a bit of information there. And also we have a terminal window here. We'll go back to that in a little bit. Over on the left-hand side, we have a tree structure showing essentially the default files that get created when we first start the Cloud9 account. And we have a search bar. We have the file view, which is the one we're looking at, the tree structure. And notice in here that we have source control. So we're tied in with GitHub as it is with this environment. So if you're thinking about it, we are developing in the cloud and storing our code in the cloud in GitHub. So we could download from GitHub, work on our code, and upload back to GitHub. And the last option here is AWS Explorer. I haven't delved into this. So notice in here in the terminal that we have all of our Linux environment commands. List, we have present working directory. So all of these things are in here. Now, let's go ahead and start interacting with GitHub. Clear our terminal and say git init. Okay, it's created an empty repository. Now we say git clone. And now we have to give it the URL of our source code. So for that, we're going to go over here to another tab, GitHub. And this is a project that I've got in GitHub, in my GitHub account. And of course, if you remember, we go into code and we select the address for this source. And here then, now that we've copied it to the clipboard, we can go ahead and say highlight there and then say Control V. As soon as we do that, it goes ahead and clones our directory. Now, if we say ls, we see that our directory is there. cd muf scraper ls-la, we see our code is right there. Now, one thing that you might have noticed is that your code also populated here in the tree structure under files. If we expand that, we have the contents in the tree structure of our working directory. If we double click on this Python file, for example, it gets brought up to the main screen. The other thing we could do here is put in stops for debugging. And for debugging, all we do is click on this bug icon right here and then start running it. So for that, we do run. Once we have clicked run, we see now that we have this error coming up immediately, which says that the requests module is not in here. So let's go ahead and close that and get requests. So for that, we do pip install requests library or module, and that installs requests, which is required in our code right up here. So now that we have that, we can try debugging one more time. We say run, and we can go ahead and say, okay, run it in debug mode. And now when we do that and we click run, it'll go ahead and go up to this point, and you see your stop is now showing a yellow arrow that's blinking. So this is where the execution of the code is. And also you notice that these options up here have become enabled. So we're going to step into the code and we're going to go ahead and say that criteria was fulfilled. Those variables are set. This conditional is tested. The first item in this particular file or in this particular code is actually true. So then it's going to print something. So there you go, it prints. So that's showing that this, we can step through the code and continue going. So this is how you would debug. When you're done debugging, you unclick that fellow. The bug goes from green to gray, so that's a done deal. And then you can go ahead and close up your debugger. You can go ahead and do that. Run, and it finishes running. So we stop that, close. Now the other thing to notice is that, let's go ahead and clear our terminal. We can go ahead and work on this code. And for this change, we're going to make a quick change. Go from 30 in this spacing to 31. Now, once we do that, notice that just like in VS Code, your little X turns into a little circle. So it's telling us that it's not saved. So we save it. It asks us to confirm the save, and we've saved it. Great. So now we have git status. And it says, sure, you've modified scraper.py, and it's different from the one up in GitHub. So what we do now is we want to add the file. We say git add scraper.py, and now we have git status. And we notice that it turned from red over here to green. It's essentially saying that it's been added. It's in the queue right now, but we haven't committed it yet, which is the next step. So we're going to commit our changes. And for that, we're going to commit minus M. And we're going to just put in our message here, changed spacing to 31. We do that and it's committed. Git push to that address. And it's going to ask us for the username of that GitHub account. And it's going to ask us for the GitHub password. With the new authentication provided by GitHub, we have to actually go into the GitHub site. Up here on the upper left-hand corner, we get the drop-down and go to settings. And then at the very bottom, there's the option for developer settings. We click that. And over here at the very bottom there, it says personal access tokens. Create the classic token. I've already created one, but if you didn't have one, you would generate a new one. So once you have that, you can then go back here. And if we go here now, highlight that space and do a Control V. When you do Control V, nothing seems to have pasted, but it's actually pasted it in there. Then you click Return, and there you go. Now you've gone ahead and uploaded or pushed your changes up into GitHub. So as a final quick check, we go into GitHub and we see that this file right here has this change spacing to 31 comment. And if you look in here, the previous version in red had 30, and this is a change that we just did. So what we've done is we've actually implemented a change in AWS Cloud 9. And by the way, we can go back to our recently worked on file just by clicking on the plus icon here and selecting the file that we were working on. And we've gone ahead and used GitHub to upload our changes. And we verified that in GitHub, our changes are indeed checked in. So this is cloud developing using a cloud source repository. And that is all done in a service from Amazon called Amazon Web Services Cloud 9. That's the end of this video. Hopefully it was useful.